Now to the water supply. It looks like winter rains are going to mean that most people on the Central Coast are not going to have to face new water restrictions this summer. But in the Santa Clara Valley Water District, water board members voted last night to continue their mandatory water cutbacks despite the wettest winter we have had in years. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen has that story for us. She's live in Salinas.
Well, Dan, this year we've seen more rainfall than, of course, we've seen in several years, but that's not enough for board members. They're concerned that without the word mandatory, water users won't pay attention to voluntary conservation. This was Anderson Reservoir Wednesday.
Anderson is our largest reservoir, and it holds about 90,000 acre-feet of water.
All 10 of the Santa Clara Valley Water District's reservoirs are full.
The reservoirs are looking pretty good, about 70% of capacity.
But that's not enough for the Water District Board to drop water restrictions already in place.
Right now we have a 15% mandatory conservation message out there. And what the board decided on yesterday was to scale that back to 10% mandatory.
Santa Clara is the only nearby county to enforce water cutbacks and says restrictions will continue.
Just because we had one good year after three dry years, it doesn't mean that we're out of the woods.
San Benito County has never had to impose water restrictions, but does enforce a water wasting rule.
There is a water waste ordinance that's in effect. It has been for quite some time, and that's primarily to keep people from overwatering their yards and creating runoff into the gutter.
Both Santa Clara and San Benito water agencies continue to encourage wise landscaping choices.
If you were to pull out the turf and put in drought-tolerant plants, we would offer a rebate for that.
We've really stressed landscape irrigation this year. We've opened up a demonstration garden down on 6 and Palin. Being efficient with water, because it's a finite resource, we only have so much of it.
We're not sure what's in store for us next year or the year after, so we always have to be adopting a lifestyle of conservation.
Santa Clara Valley Water District provides water to 13 different retailers, and in the end, it's up to them and to local cities as to whether or not they actually enforce or disregard the district's call for conservation. Dan.
All right. Thanks very much, Brittany. This plan isn't being espoused by everybody. The critics say if water users are always asked to conserve, they're not going to take a request seriously when there really is a serious drought.